G'day, Jacob from Make Science Fun here. Thanks for joining me today. Today we're looking at projectile motion. First, I've got a laminar stream of water. I'm going to turn on the vibrating device now. The tube is being vibrated at 50 times per second, or 50 hertz. Turn off the lights, and then I turn on the strobe light. Yes! Wow! Look at that! The water droplets appear to freeze in the air. Now, there are no editing effects here. What you're seeing on the screen is exactly what I'm seeing in real life. The light is flashing 50 times a second, but that means it's dark 50 times a second as well. And while it's dark, each drop moves to the next position, and then we see it in the next position. So I've matched the frequency of the strobe to the frequency of the droplets, which is 50 hertz exactly. Here, I'm slightly increasing the frequency of the strobe light, which causes the drops to appear to go upwards. It's only an optical illusion though. Now I'm going to decrease the frequency of the strobe, and the droplets will appear to move forward. Again, this is really only an optical illusion. With projectile motion, the horizontal distance between the drops remains constant, but the vertical distance increases because the droplets are accelerating downwards with gravity. So with each increment of time, the vertical displacement gets larger as the vertical speed increases due to the acceleration of gravity. Now put some 5mm grid lines behind the droplets. This will allow you to pause the video and actually take some measurements. Now the time between each droplet is 0.02 seconds and the grid lines are 5mm apart. Hey guys, you're probably wondering how I made this happen. Well, I've got a container of water here with a tube that goes up through this little machine here. Now what this little machine does is it hits the tube 50 times a second. Bang, 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 bang. It's a ticker tape timer. You might have used one at school. And so it produces fine little drops, 50 drops a second. And that stream comes out the end of that tube. Then I get the strobe light and I turn the strobe light on 50 times a second. I turn the rest of the lights off, and then you get that image that you saw with the droplets frozen in the air. Oh well, now you know. Real Lego, real science, real good. Thanks heaps for joining me today. I hope you've learnt something new. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.